Araça azul é sonho segredo. Não é segredo.
I've been thinking about fear for a long time. The specificity of fear. It's interesting, but also I think because I'm interested in psychoanalysis, but it's important that every person is scared of one very specific thing. And I think that makes us to think about individuality and to think how different we are from each other and what defines us. I've done this project called I Wish Your Wish, which was a collection of wishes from different people, and I've been collecting those wishes for, I don't know, maybe one decade. It varies a lot from place to place, from country to country. And what I've noticed is that the wishes might hide some fears. The plan was to do workshop with kids from four different schools in London. We showed capes in different circumstances and situations, like from superhero capes to animals, and also artists using capes in general. They had to make a drawings of capes that potentially would protect them against their own fears. So that was one part of the project, working with the kids, and I'm very thankful to all of them, because without their collaboration, nothing would have happened. So after that, I invited a friend of mine called Lucas Nascimento. He's a fashion designer, and I asked him to help me sort of translating the kids' drawing into an interesting sort of cape that they could wear. It's like translating poetry, I suppose. It's very difficult, but I think there's an element of freedom on doing this sort of translation too.
Não é segredo.
All the materials also try to be conceptually related to the cape or what they represent and the fear. For instance, the material defines a lot of things, so in this case I just took advantage of the fabric, the black fabric, and added the words, and because it was guns and knives, I thought that a metal letter would look good. He specified a few things in this cape, but he was afraid of clown. Another kid, his or her fear was phoenix, which I thought was very interesting because it's not a common fear, so to say, but it's a scary mythical creature. So this guy was scared of biscuit crumbs. In my reading, in a way, I maybe hides like a mother screaming out, you know, be aware of those crumbs on the bed or something like this. So it could be that one word, one specific fear, is just hiding a bigger fear. So this one, the kid did this drawing, and she or he wrote, a glow-in-the-dark cape. So we interpreted like having glow-in-the-dark stars and the yellow. So a lot of things we respect from the original drawing, like the colors, the shapes, the elements that help identify the fears. And some capes would actually combine two different fears. Like, for instance, there's one cape and it says end of the world and has a spider. This one, she was afraid of fire, and she had the water getting rid of the fires. I just picked up her drawing and enlarged it, and we made an embroidered out of felt. So that's the kid's drawing, and that's like the interpretation from the fashion designer. And in this case, the fear I attach it to the cape has nothing to do with a bee. It's written horror movies. So some capes can combine to kind of break this didactical dimension that one cape could have. This is already a bee. It represents a bee. So I thought of adding a more interesting dimension on the Cape when you have a written word. I think this makes things more complex in a way, and I like that. The name of Fear, and took me a while to find this title.
Não é
segredo. Listening to Caetano Veloso, who is a singer and a composer that I like very much, there is one song from an album that I love called Araçá Azul. Araçá Azul is a fruit. It's a fruit from northeast of Brazil. So it says Araçá Azul is the most beautiful name of a fear. So I came up with this name, which is taken from Caetano's song.
Eu não vou morrer tão cedo. Com fé em Deus, eu não vou morrer tão cedo. Araçá Azul é brinquedo.